Hello? 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 Anybody there? Fine! I didn't want to talk to you anyway. Sorry. Here's the real deal. Sometimes people don't want to talk to you. Sometimes they don't want to hear from you. And as savvy marketers, it's probably best that we keep our database clean and only talk to those people who are really interested in the conversation. In this Sprocket Talk tutorial, that's exactly what I'm going to show you, is how to import an opt-out list that got meta, kind of nerdy, but let's keep it simple. Let's dive into this right now. Remember, if you need education past this tutorial, that's what we do, weekly training or 1 and 2 day workshops. Check the description below. Let's get into the portal. Let's help you get this job done. As you can see, I am in HubSpot and we need to upload an opt-out list for some people who do not want to get emails anymore, or for a list that we may have used a third party to cleanse as we're bringing in new contacts into a database. To do that, we're going to go over to contacts, and under contacts we're going to go ahead and click on lists. Once we're in lists, we are going to look for the import button over here. We'll click the import button. So once the page loads, we're going to head over to this start and import button here. Now there are these directions that you can look at for spreadsheets and how they work in HubSpot, but in this case we're just going to go to the task that we want to do, and usually we select a CSV file because we're doing a regular import, but you're going to notice right next to that there is an opt-out list, and so HubSpot automatically will know what we're trying to do with this list. We're going to go ahead and click in the opt-out list. We're going to go ahead and select a file, and we're going to look in our downloads for this file right here. We're going to go ahead and open that. It's going to upload it, and you're going to see that we have the upload button here, and we can see that we'll have details and confirmation here. It's a three-step process. We'll go ahead and hit that upload. It's going to go ahead and upload email field column header. That is one thing you're going to want to make sure, that there is an email in this Excel spreadsheet, because that's basically what it's going to go through your contacts and look for any matching emails. And if there is a matching email in the spreadsheet and in your contact database, then it's going to go ahead and opt them out of getting email from you. And what we'll do is we'll go ahead and go next to confirm your choice. It will let us know, in this case, all 7,612 contacts in this list will no longer receive any emails from your organization. Please be extraordinarily sure. Yeah, we're sure. And then we have to type in the number to import this list. So we'll go ahead and type that in, and we'll go ahead and hit begin import. Now, one thing I will tell you is making sure that these opt-out lists are correct is very important, but also making sure that you're using opt-out lists are very important. One of the things that we hear HubSpot users complain about is deliverability, yet they don't want to complain about keeping their databases clean, about not getting a lot of bounced or spam reports in what they're sending out. So definitely make sure you do this. But look, when it comes to importing an opt-out list inside of HubSpot, it's just that simple. It's just that easy. So you see, getting a small amount, or in some cases, a mass amount of people opted out of your emails because they no longer want to be part of the conversation, it's not that difficult. But make sure that you go and check your database. Make sure you're keeping your database clean. Make sure you're having the conversation with the right people at the right time. Do business in a human way. As always, this is your boy, George B. from Impulse Creative, saying happy HubSpotting. Oh yeah, make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the bell for instant notifications, or do one of these things.